Joining us now is Senator Bart Hester. Senator Bart Hester, you've been serving as a senator of Arkansas for a couple of years now. You were district number one, but there are some changes coming now in 2023, including the district that you're a part of and also your position. So tell us a little bit about the changes that we'll see coming from you.
Well, we've seen the entire state of Arkansas and the country went through redistricting. Mm-hmm. And so the district I represent used to be one, now it's 33, but it's shrunk in about half because I was representing almost 200,000 people. And so that's exciting that we're getting a lot of growth and actually more representation in Northwest Arkansas. But I've recently been elected by my colleagues to be the president of the Senate for the next 2 years. And so that's really exciting that I'll be having the opportunity to lead the Senate moving into the 2023.
So what does your position entail? What are some of your responsibilities?
Well, I think the responsibility is just make sure that the Senate is organized well, mm-hmm. running efficiently when we meet, when we take breaks, mm-hmm. And hopefully just aligning on some goals and that we're going to reach for, and hopefully I'll be leading on those goals, which I think I will be, which will be on education, income tax, and prison reform.
Okay, we'll talk about those issues coming up in a little bit, but also as your role, you've been in talks with Governor-elect Sarah Huckabee Sanders. What kind of conversations have you been having with her?
Well, I've been having very routine conversations with her staff. Mm-hmm. Right, she's got a lot of hiring to do and a lot of things, sure, that she's focused on. Been just talking. I mean, in fact, I had a call with them this morning. Have a call almost every day with her. With our team, just mm-hmm. again, just working on organizing, making sure that we're going to be, regardless of what the policies are, that we are organized and we're all working well together and communicating well.
What do you think will be different with, from your perspective, with her administration than it was with Governor Asa Hutchinson's administration?
Well, I think we're going to experience very similar the first session that we did to Governor Hutchinson's. When you got a new governor coming in, everyone's super excited about it. Mm-hmm. And so the legislature is probably going to give Governor-elect Sanders pretty much anything she asked for. Now, we're going to have some direction on how we're going to get there, but I think there's going to be a lot of support behind the things that Governor-elect Sanders has campaigned on.
You've been talking about education. Governor-elect Sarah Huckabee Sanders has been talking a lot about education. What has the conversation look like when it comes to education in Arkansas?
Well, it's going to be very focused on students winning. We're not going to be focused on institutions winning, but really focused on students and teachers winning. I think it's going to be a really exciting time if you're a public school mm-hmm. teacher in Arkansas, if you're a teacher at all in Arkansas. We're going to look at repealing some things back that are burdening our teachers down and keeping them from really focused on what they want to do in the classroom. We're going to pay our teachers better. And really, all of that is going to be ultimately focused on the student and educating the kids of Arkansas.
Now, the current governor proposed $550 million towards teacher pay. Has that come up? Has that conversation come up?
Well, that conversation has come up, and it's really easy to propose some huge spending when you leave. And so I don't fault Governor Hutchinson for that, but he's not responsible for the next budget. This legislature and the incoming governor is going to be. So we are going to pay teachers more money. That's an exciting thing. We're going to do that. We're going to remove some burdens for them, and we're going to spend a lot more money in education. But what we're going to do is really make sure that the money we are spending is spent well. Mm-hmm. We're already spending 44 cents of every tax dollar that comes in, we are spending on K-12 education, mm-hmm. and over 50 cents per dollar if you look at higher education as well.
But teacher salary, you are looking to increase.
I would absolutely say, pending some collapse in the economy, mm-hmm. that we absolutely intend to increase teacher pay in Arkansas.
Okay. And what are some of the restrictions that teachers are under right now that you are looking at to remove?
Well, you know, we're not talking yet about very specific things, but what we do know is you hear from teachers all the time that every time we meet, we add another thing for them to do in a day. And all those things are good things, right? But at the end of the day, you've got so many good things, we're not focused on the great things like reading literacy, math. And so we're really going to try to remove some of the good things to make sure that kids can, the students and teachers focus on what's most important.
Okay, can you focus on reading right now? I heard you mention earlier about we're just not at a reading level that we should be, especially mm-hmm. for younger children.
Well, that's right. All over Arkansas, only one-third of students are reading at grade level. And so the word is, if you're not reading by the third grade at grade level, mm-hmm. then you never get caught up hardly. So we're really going to hone in at those early ages on whatever it takes to make sure that we're reading great at third grade, because by the time you're in the fourth or fifth grade, even your math is requiring lots of reading. So we're really going to really focus in on the early ages of students, making sure they're reading well.
I know that you're a Republican, you have majority majority Republican for sure in the House and Senate. Some Democrats think that there should be pre-K education. Is that something that you might consider to get moving up to speed?
Sure. I think the pre-K is a very valid argument. I think it works, but it's one of those things that I would qualify as a good thing, not the great thing. And we've got to keep our focus on the great thing, which is reading by the third grade, keep our efforts focused in right there. Pre-K is a good thing. I think we really want to hope that parents are staying home or focused when they're at home with their kids doing the pre-K work themselves.
Okay. Another good thing, you were talking about sports and maybe some extracurriculars. Mm-hmm. Are you thinking to remove some of those programs in order to put more focus on reading, or are we putting more money into reading? Like, how is that going to work?
Well, I say we're not looking to remove sports, right? But again, obviously, we got to focus on what is most important in Arkansas. And what we do know is the schools that are spending the most money on athletics are reading the worst at third grade, right? And the schools that are spending the most money in third grade and kindergarten and reading are just most money in kindergarten, first, second, third grade are outperforming those schools with what's most important.
So academics, reading comes first.
The schools in Arkansas that are spending the money on academics are performing well. When they're spending money on the athletics, maybe they're doing well with athletics, but they're not reading. So we got to focus back on saying, hey, it's great that we got a big football stadium. It's great that we got a lot of football coaches. It's great that we're doing all these things. We want to win and be great athletes as well, but we want our kids to read first.
Okay. All right, Senator Bart Hester, we're out of time for this block, but we're going to be back in 2 more minutes here on 4029 News on the Record. Welcome back to 4029 News on the Record. We're continuing our conversation with Senator Bart Hester, who's a new Senate president in 2023. So congratulations on that position. You are focusing on two other issues that we haven't gotten to yet, including the prison reform. The need, everyone says, is there for more beds. So what are your thoughts on that? Where are we going to build this new prison if we build it?
Right now, we're kind of surveying all of Arkansas, saying, hey, which county, who wants a new prison built in your county? Because many counties are going to say, no, we're not interested in that. But some, and hopefully one, will say, hey, we're very interested in that. We want that. We want the jobs that come with that. And the reality, at the end of the day, the number one job of government is to keep people safe. And we've got to have the beds in a growing state that we keep repeat violent offenders locked up. We don't want to put them back out on our streets. And when they're on our streets, they're going to cost us all money, whether it's breaking into your home, breaking into your car, maybe some sort of physical violence against an individual. But we've got to have the beds to keep repeat violent offenders locked up.
How great is the need in Arkansas?
Well, the need currently is over 1,000 beds. We're over 1,000 beds. We're backed up into our we are backed up from our state prisons into our county jails. That's why we just even went through in Benton County and all over the state needing prison expansions in our county jails, because we're backed up with state prisoners. So we've got to build a statewide jail, get some of these bad guys out of our local prisons and put where they should be.
And it was Benton, Washington, Madison counties that had the ballot issues that had wanted to expand and get more money to build a bigger, expand jails or build one as far as Madison County is concerned. About what percentage or how great, what numbers are we talking about when we say we need those 1,000 beds so we can alleviate the responsibility from our local sheriff's departments?
Well, I think the Department of Corrections is saying maybe 1,000 beds. I think that the information that I'm getting is saying we might need up to 3,000 or 3,500 beds, but a 3,000 bed prison would cost us about $750 million. And then it's about $60 per night per prisoner. I mean, the expense is real. Luckily, in Arkansas, we've been very fiscally responsible. We have the money to do that. I believe it's the number one priority. We want to keep people safe, and if they're safe, then we can educate them. And if we got a safe society that's educated, we can get people some really good jobs and attract good jobs to Arkansas.
And who's going to run that? Is it going to be the state, or are we looking for private companies possibly?
Well, we're certainly looking for the state to do that. Some of my colleagues aren't interested in private businesses running jails. I'm okay with that personally, but I believe that we're looking at the state running the prison facilities for us.
Is that an issue that's going to come up on day one? What is it, January 10th?
Well, one of the things I'm comfortable saying in my discussions with Governor-elect Sanders is she wants it all day one. She doesn't want to mess around. She's not interested in government and politics as usual. She wants to go to work, hit the ground running hard on day one, and we plan to do that.
Okay, well, what about income taxes?
Income taxes, that's something that I think we all agree that we want to pay less taxes. That's Democrat, Republican, but then what do you do when you have less revenues? And so where we are, we want to be responsible in our tax cuts. We've been responsible in Arkansas. We continue to cut them, and our revenues keep rising. So we want to cut taxes. We want to cut them responsibly. But Governor Alex Sanders campaigned, as many of us did, on cutting the income tax more in Arkansas. We're at 4.9%. I expect us to continue to do that.
Okay. And how low you want to get that to?
Well, we're on a path to zero. Now, okay. I don't know if that path is a 30-year path or a 3-year path, but we're going to continue to look at that. And again, when we can cut taxes responsibly while continuing to provide the services that are necessary, we want to do that.
And are you looking for all levels of income? Doesn't matter how much you make, you want it to all be zero.
That's right. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can kind of mention it as a flat tax, right?
Okay.
In Arkansas, at this point, we've smashed our brackets down to where as the top bracket comes down, mm-hmm. all payers underneath pay less as well. So we're not to a point anymore of picking winners and losers, mm-hmm. higher income versus lower income, cutting taxes. If we cut taxes now, it's a win for everyone.
And this is a conversation that you had with Governor-elect Sarah Huckabee Sanders?
Well, it's a conversation I continue to have with her staff. Mm-hmm. I think all of the state of Arkansas had this conversation with her while she was running. She was very clear every time she spoke. She was on a path to zero income tax. We as the legislature agree with her on that, and we're going to work hard on it.
All right. Senator Hester, thanks so much for joining us today on 4020 90s on the Record.
Thank you for having me.
We'll be back.